Miles, good to see you here.
Morning.
I was commenting on the name plackets. I hadn't seen those previously. Have you seen that before? Have your name on it?
Only for about 5 or 10 years.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Is there a hearing today, Mr. Miles?
I don't have anything to say to either of you two gentlemen. I'm here because I'm an attorney for the Civil Service Board.
Attorney for? I thought you were a hearing officer.
I am that too.
Oh, well, is this a hearing? I thought it was just a regular meeting.
I just wanted to know. I see everybody's titles on there, and I just was curious who everybody was.
So we've got to the point that you can't talk to anybody now? Is that where we're at, Mr. Miles? You're an attorney getting paid $200-something an hour. Don't you feel some responsibility to speak to the public?
My job is to represent my client.
Mr.
Miles, I don't desire to engage in any conversation with you, sir. So
well,
thank you very much.
I'm paying you, so you work for me. Comes out of my pocket and goes into yours. I'm your boss.
I don't believe that's true, Mr. Miles.
I know it's true.
You pay ad valorem taxes in this county?
I sure do.
Oh, you still own property after Mr. Banks' judgment against you?
I sure do.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, Smith.
How are you?
All right. Where am I sitting?
Right here.
Right here. There you go. Charity's over there.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That's Charity.
That's Charity.
Oh, I thought you said those.
I'm sorry.
How are you?
Hey, good to see you, Smith.
Howdy.
Extending the greeting. I appreciate you.
Sir?
I appreciate you extending the greeting.
Thank
you.
Okay. Oh, boy, this room's as big as the one upstairs.
It ain't big enough, is it?
I've got 7 inch stereo. A few more minutes than that.
Mm-hmm.
Good morning.
Come on.
I asked Mr. Miles if this was a hearing. He's, I think, a hearing officer, I believe, is what he was hired on for. That's what the rules say, that he can only be here when the county commissioners approve his appearance here as a hearing officer, and he said this wasn't a hearing, so I asked him politely, you know, why was he here? Was this a hearing? And he said he didn't have anything to say, but he didn't want to talk to me. So. But I'm just curious if, whether or not this is to be construed as a hearing since he's here.
Well, I'm not a legal mind, so.
I did tell Mr. Miles I'm attorney for the board.
Sure.
And we have a meeting today, obviously, because he's here as well.
I just wonder if that's what the guidelines say, though, Terry. It doesn't say that you can hire an attorney.
Is that general counsel? Would that be the same, Mr. Miles, as attorney for the board?
Yeah, I do.
I think the general counsel for the county is Mr. Gerard. I'm counsel or attorney for the Civil Service Board.
I know that there was talk or mention of a general counsel mentioned for the board, but the Board of Commissioners failed to include that in their resolution that they made, and that's why I was inquiring as to what capacity you were in, if you were here as hearing officer, which I assume you are because you've got the title there, Leading as Hearing Officer. That's would be my concern or point, that if you were their general counsel of the board, or were you the hearing officer of the board, or what capacity were you hearing? Are you possibly in both?
It's my understanding that the Board of Commissioners has allowed the Civil Service Board and approved Mr. Miles to be here as the board sees fit. I haven't been directed any differently.
I'd seen that resolution, and they had just included hearing officer and...
And that's the title that he, you know, he has.
Under the Civil Service Board rules, it gave, I think, four functions for a hearing officer, and I think counsel, general counsel, wasn't labeled as one of those. That's why I was wondering if y'all were going to retain Mr. Miles as your general counsel, similar to what you had done for the hearing officer.
I assume we would.
Okay, thank you.
Five to one starting now.
No, we're gonna start at 10. Make sure that everybody has the ability to be here at 10, that wants to be. Do you vote?
Yep.
I'll see you.
Terry, I know it's not your fault, but they had to unlock the door for me to get here. Having them here behind a locked door breaks, would take rule. I know that's not your fault, because they said all the other meetings were full, and they had to put you down here. But anyway, you know, we might have to have this rule as an illegal meeting since he's behind a locked door.
We're at the discretion of where the county wants to put us.
And I don't think you need to be here. I think you need to be where the county business is going on up here. County administration, but where it used to be.
I can even show you in the guidebook that the governor of Georgia State provided where it talks about it, if you'd like, you could help shop them out. It's a pretty easy read right here, this book here. I don't know if you've ever seen it, but it's pretty interesting, open meetings, and it talks about some of the items that are important.
That's the link that I emailed to you, members of the board earlier this week.
I read it, and I appreciate it.
You're very welcome. You're welcome, Mr. Smith. I refrained from emailing it to Mr. Miles because I didn't want to charge the county $26 for reading a single email from me.
I think he's familiar with it.
Actually, I don't think so.
It says meetings not held at the regular posted time or place require more rigorous notice procedures. And so when you change rooms or something, they have some other concerns.
Mr. Meadows, we're a bunch of orphans. We do not know from one yesterday where we're meeting here. The sheriff's office is trained, firemen all are trained here. We've met in all the upstairs in the past. This is the first time I've been down here, I've been in, but we don't know until we get here. Where are we meeting today? We'll have hours up the Civil Service Board.
Well, we do know before we get here because Ms. Clerk notifies us where we're going to be, but we don't know from 1 month to the next meeting where we'll be.
We just know we'll be in this building, that's it.
I understand your concern, I appreciate your concern. But the county is responsible for providing us a meeting place. And we have not taken it up with the county, but we work with the county wherever they tell us to meet. And if we're not meeting according to this book or the guidelines, then it should be taken up with Ms. Clark, Mr. Gerard, and Mr. Tain. We're just citizens, and we don't set the policy. We just go wherever we're told to go.
We realize that, and we want to help you rectify that problem.
And I appreciate the help, and I would suggest that if you take it up with the Board of Commissioners, the county manager, Mr. Gerard, and Ms. Clark, then we'll go wherever they tell us to go.
I'll assure you we will address that.
And I hope that you do.
Sure.
Where it will be clear.
Isn't that the responsibility of this board and their hearing officer, though, as chairman and members of a duly elected board and duly authorized board, if that's the case, that y'all would communicate as a request and that there's a vehicle provided for in the Civil Service Board rules that y'all make recommendations or requests to the Board of Commissioners? Have y'all made a request, as you mentioned, for y'all to have something such that y'all can abide by the state of Georgia rules so that y'all can, you know, regularly meet at the same place, or if you're not, to at least have the time frame necessary to allow the public, the press, and others to know where they're going? It just is a suggestion before your meeting starts.
And we'll take that into consideration.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. I appreciate it.
It's 10 o'clock, Mr. Chairman.
I got 1 minute till. If you're all ready, we'll start.
Okay, you're on the record.
Okay, if the side county public service Be part of the civil service board of South County when I come to order. This is a regular meeting day. It's Thursday, March 10th, 2001, 10 a.m. We're meeting in the public safety complex, 911 conference room. We call it the bottom level, I believe. Is that correct? Is that right, Ms. Clark?
Yes.
Bottom level, okay. Present for this meeting is Terry Smith, Ms. John Blanchard, Avery Howell. Also, Ms. Clerk, our secretary, Mr. Dana Miles, our hearing officer. Let me say, Ms. Clerk, that you've done a good job, I think, of advertising this meeting because it's in the county website, county administration building, in the lobby, county calendar, front door of the public complex. It's also in the Atlanta Constitution. And by the way, Atlanta Constitution does a good job here. The first time I seen it, it says what, when, where, and what it means to you. So that's the first time I've seen it. I don't know if we've covered all the things we're supposed to cover, but I think that pretty well tells you where we're going to be meeting. Mr. Blanchard, have you and Ms. Smith had a chance to read the minutes of the last meeting, which was...
Mr. Chairman, you might want to identify the picture there.
Well, okay, I will. Visiting with us, Mr. David Milam. Mr. Brian Meadows.
Brent Meadows, B-R-E-N-T.
Brent, I beg your pardon, I got Brian. B-R-E-N-T. Ms. Nydia, Tisdale.
Nydia Tisdale, yes, sir.
Is it Nydia?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
That's a very lovely name.
Thank you so much.
And Ms. Harrington, the South County News with us. Anyone else that you left out? All right. Ms. Smith, have you and Mr. Blanchard both had a chance to read the minutes of the last meeting? Let me make one little change. You don't mind the other beam. And you miss. We drop down here under this Tisdale. The civil service board acknowledges that. Mark through the vein, put it. You see a letter from the board of ethics.
I made that change.
Fine. All right. Did we do a second on that?
I make a motion they be approved as written with the correction. You
right.
My second time.
All in favor of the motion is written, say aye.
Aye.
The vote. Dropping down to old business. Charles Adams,
on that, and the next item, which would be Mr. Gooch's writ of cert, both of those are still pending in Superior Court. No hearing date's been set, no action has been taken. So they're in the same holding pattern that they were as of last month. No new report to the board.
All right, just chance that. Has that been?
I have a report on that, Mr. Chairman. On February the 25th, we filed our response on behalf of the Civil Service Board with our answer and certification of the record. And so Ms. Clark and I filed that response. She actually hand-delivered it to the courthouse with all of the records and exhibits that were tendered in the chance hearing. The exception is, as of February the 25th, the transcript had not been completely prepared. The parties for both sides, Mr. Chance's lawyer and the county's lawyer, entered into a stipulation allowing for an extension of time. I think there's waiting on the court reporter to get it done, and we anticipate that that will be done, you know, here very shortly in the next few days or so.
And I have received an electronic copy that I'll need to deliver to the county's print room to have that printed.
But as of, right, the difficulty was that as of the date that the board was served with this, our answer, I believe, was technically due on the 28th of February, and I didn't want to wait till the very last day, so I filed it on, we filed on Friday the 25th, and noted in our answer that here's everything we've got, except for the transcript, which is in the process of being prepared, and we had anticipated it would be prepared and done sometime this week or the following week, and that's why both parties that
mean, you're technically a party to the appeal, but in reality, it's Mr. Chance versus the county.
Right. On appeal. And our duty under a writ of cert is just to certify the record and file a response. And of course, part of our response denies that we committed any error that would justify overturning the decision this board has made.
So,
I'm glad to answer any questions the board has.
Mr. Miles, yes, this constitution bill was for today's. It says second appeal by Mr. Jeff Chance to Superior Court. Is this another time or is this the original appeal?
Well, I think they are maybe misunderstanding exactly how it works under the law, but if you look at the hearing in front of this board as his first appeal, then I could see how a layman might interpret what he's doing in Superior Court as a second appeal, but it's really not. Because the hearing is in front of this board, and then if there's an error that has been committed as a matter of law, then the Superior Court has jurisdiction to address that.
Well,
in other words, they won't have a de novo hearing in Superior Court. They won't present all the evidence all over again. The evidence was presented to this board, and you made your decision, and then the Superior Court either will affirm it or, overturn it. What direction is as to what to do?
Mr. Miles, also along that line, it says that there's a Monday and Tuesday next week, there'll be pre-hearing conference with Judge Pike. I've got that somewhere else. Have you seen that in the Constitution? I assume that they always have that pre-conference, so to speak, before it's...
It wouldn't surprise me if one of the attorneys has requested that just from a scheduling perspective. I haven't received that yet.
Well, I was in the paper, and I wonder why we jumped all the way down to the farm again. We had two here in court for how long? A year and a half?
Because it's probably, and this is speculation on my part, it's probably just a scheduling conference. We're going to do this by this date, this by that date, have motions filed, hearing by such and such a date. That's speculation.
Will this one fall in behind the Adams and the Goods one?
Theoretically, it should.
So it could be 2 years before that.
Could be.
Did you mention this before? Statute of limitations. Is there a statute of limitations, as far as you know, or not?
Well, no. The appeal was done timely to the Superior Court. The writ of cert is done timely, and the problem is not that. It's one that we're facing all over the state due to cuts in the judicial budget. There's an increase in number of cases, and there's not any more judges, and we don't have enough room in the courthouse even if we had additional judges. So the courts are unfortunately behind. I believe that Judge Dickinson and Judge Bagley are working as hard as they can, but there's only so many hours in the day, and when there's more cases filed than they can possibly adjudicate, they just take them as best they can. We've qualified for a third Superior Court judge here for quite some time. Mm-hmm. We don't have space to put them.
And no money's been allocated either, so.
Well, until we get a new courthouse built, which hopefully will happen under the next floss, that would be, that would allow us to be able to get a little bit more current.
Right.
It's not the judge's fault, I assure you.
I'm aware of that.
Let's drop down to updates on civil service policy legislation. Before we get into that, Ms. Clark, you want to explain that to us?
Well, I just had placed this under old business after the last meeting. Of course, Mr. Gerard came and advised the board on the different policies and legislation that the Board of Commissioners was looking at. But since he's been here, I don't have anything new to report at this point in time.
One of the main changes we saw there was the 9 votes to elect a member, elected official to elect a member to this board. That has been changed. I understand Mr. Gerard has met with us here before. The commissioners together had 1 vote. 5 on accumulated vote 1 time. That's been changed now that each commission gets a vote. Also, I believe it's another change that the probate judge has no one under civil service in his office. He's been having a vote, they've taken that vote away, is that correct?
I think that was going to be the discussion that Mr. Gerard was going to have with Judge Jordan.
And the chief magistrate judge, Mr. Brant, will be voted elected.
That is the discussion.
So what we got here is the sheriff, the clerk of court, tax commissioner, and Brant?
The chief magistrate.
Chief magistrate.
Chief magistrate. That's one.
And that's the one in the five.
In the five commissioners.
Well, I'm sure that's fine, but it's four, and the reason, I think the reason of all was that the commission had accumulated voted up one. This way, it will, all the commission vote is blocked, all five of them vote, of course, that means that the other four are overruled. So it does give a lot of power, authority to, as far as an election, to a member of this board, to the commissioners. So they've got five, and another elected official's got four. I just noticed that.
Ms. Clerk, have they scheduled a public hearing for any?
I have not seen any updates on that to see that it's gotten, I believe that the last direction given was that Ms. Carson and Mr. Gerard were supposed to bring the changes and that were discussed back to a work session to the commissioners, and I haven't seen that on a work session. Yeah, I will check with Ms. Carson on where they stand with getting those updates.
Well, I don't know if it would take a motion or not, but you are in conversation with them, and you might pass on, and I'll be glad to make it in the form of a motion that you pass on to Mr. Gerard and the commissioners that, you know, some of the items that need to be addressed in the public hearing, which would probably need to change, would be one, that the Civil Service Board would have the right to have counsel present at the meetings, called in whatever manner, whatever name that the Mr. Gerard would like to call it. And also, you could bring to their attention, and this is part of my motion, that you call to their attention that some of the issues have been raised as far as our meeting room.
Okay.
The Civil Service Board has no authority to assign themselves a room, but the county does, and that we would like for them to address that situation.
Okay.
That's the end of my motion.
I second that.
All in favor of the motion as stated, say aye.
Aye.
That's unanimous. Hope we get some results. Update on the Ms. Clerk. I have a letter from the chairman of the commissioners, and I didn't worry about whether you members got one or not. Did you get a copy of it?
Did not.
I sat around it.
I will read this into the record. Is that okay, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
This is an inter-office mail to Ms. Charity Clark, Risk Manager, Public Safety Building. Dear Charity, please accept this letter as notification of your appointment as clerk to the Forsyth County Civil Service Board at their regular meeting held on Thursday, February the 17th, 2011. The Board of Commissioners unanimously approved the request from the Civil Service Board to appoint you as their clerk for 2011 calendar year. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you for your cooperation in this matter. Sincerely, Doug Dare, County Manager.
I have a copy.
Okay,
I have one.
I know we all got a copy.
I did not.
No.
But I do have a copy for the board's file.
Yeah, okay.
As well.
I've heard nothing from the board concerning the hearing us, Mr. Miles. However, on the 3rd of this month, which is a week ago today, the commissions met, three of them, and elected or appointed Mr. Miles for the year 2011. And in that vote, Mr. Tam and Mr. Bell before it, Mr. Levent was no, the other two commissions were not present. Now, I have not got a letter on that. Signed the letter for the board asking for that.
It's on the paper.
And I think the letter is forthcoming the clerk to the Board of Commissioners, I gave her Mr. Miles's address, so I believe that'll be coming soon.
You haven't done anything?
No, sir.
Okay. Anyway, that passed a week ago today, which is the workshop. That's all I know. And I hope you'll get a letter confirming that. Now, another thing brings up, said for the year 11, the dentist appointment this March. Will we start next time, next March, or we start beginning of the year?
Well, Mr. Chairman, we appointed him. We sent our recommendation in the January meeting. They just didn't get around to do it. It will come due again next January.
So we're in for the year of January.
Yes.
All right. Appreciate that. Under new business, in the old business, we still need to remember to know.
No, sir.
All right, the Civil Service Board appointment, the Board of Ethics to replace an expired term of George and Purple. I have no suggestions as far as nominating anyone for that committee. I'm not out and about like some of the rest of us, like our service clubs like Rotary and so on. But a lot more people than I do, so I've been on, back in my younger days, I was on about half a dozen of these things. Today, all my good friends have passed away. For example, Leon Bowen and I were the only original board members who started Corn School in 1948. They had a sixth anniversary and invited Leon himself, and I got a little penny. Leon and I are the only ones left, that 40 people. Got down to it. We got a JC. That's the loudest bunch I've ever worked with. He did quite a good thing. Like, delivering mail to the foot. But then you became an exhausted rooster at age 36, and most of us stayed on the 40. Anyway, but Mr. Smith, or you, Mr. Blanchard, you want to have any ones you thought of or had in mind, or that might accept this position if you ask?
Well, I, like you, don't know the higher echelon. I know more employees than do anything else.
I'm the same way. I deal with now, of course, church people. I'm sure no bad sense to be on this board.
Or Methodist, or
Presbyterian.
Or any of the others. Well,
maybe yeah, all right. Catholic, then. Anyway. Did anyone have anybody, or have you thought about it, or made any suggestions?
I've got a name that I'll throw out, and the board may want to delay it until next month to choose them. It's whatever you want to do. Is there any urgency? Is there a time limit on this, Mr. Miles, if we need to?
I'm not aware of one other than if the board needed to take some action.
Right.
It would be good to have an appointment, and of course, your appointment would be confirmed by the Board of Commissioners. So
true.
You've got a little bit of time delay. Even after you make a decision,
right.
Because it'll have to go before the board.
However, I believe the ethics ordinance allows the standing board, if they need to appoint someone if there is a vacancy. I believe their ordinance allows that, should something come up.
Right, just for the one time.
Right, right.
I know a gentleman, he's retired, so he has time to be able to spend whatever time's necessary. He's a successful businessman that moved up here a number of years ago. He was from Atlanta. He's a man of integrity, successful businessman. His name is Lauren, L-O-R-N-E, Twiner, T-W-I-N-E-R. I think that he would make an excellent member of the Ethics Board.
Is that right, what it's getting into?
I don't know. He reads a lot. I'd say that he'd have to be aware of some things.
Well, Mr. Smith, you want to go ahead and make a motion to confer with him? How you want to handle this? Don't wait another month for
it. If you don't have any other name, then I'll put his name in the nomination. If you want to check him out, if y'all want to meet him or call him into a meeting, we can do that, and then we can vote on him. Every how y'all want to do.
Let me suggest this. Excuse me. That we invite him for our next meeting. And make his acquaintance with us and see what he'll feel about that. I'm sure he'll find me. I'll take their recommendation. So, very seriously.
Maybe you can talk to him in the meantime and make sure that he understands. He may have read the paper and doesn't want any part of it.
That'll be fine. I will invite him to our next meeting.
How the next meetings went?
April.
I'll withdraw his nomination and we'll bring him.
That'll be fine. What is it, Thursday, the second Thursday?
You can leave his nomination pending. It's not been seconded or voted on.
That'll be fine.
That way, when you invite him, you can at least say that, you know, I'm not, then I will nominate.
And we'll leave it till the next meeting.
Right.
Take action.
Is it meant on a motion or just?
No, it's a motion that's not going to be seconded. Our next meeting's April the 14th.
Right, correct.
All right, so. Hopefully we're meeting him in April. Thank you very much, Ms. Smith.
And if any of y'all come up with another name, we can do that.
Well, you know a lot more people than we do now, particularly the team of service club. That's a very active service club you're in. Ms. Clerk, how many more new appeals do we have?
No new appeals have been received.
For the county at peace.
Yes, sir. County's at peace.
That's correct. Anything else need to bring up on new business?
I make a motion to adjourn.
I second that motion.
Make a motion to adjourn until the next regular meeting, which will be in.
April 14th.
April 14th. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Be unanimous. Thank you. This is good, but they don't want to keep this up.
Oh, you can keep it.
You too. Any vacations or anything recently?
Travel any?
I haven't.
I've been wanting one, I tell you what. This winter's gone on long, hasn't it?
It's been a coldest one I've been through. Maybe it's, I'm just getting old.
I was in South America. It was 85 degrees. I got roses above our house over there. That big. Okay, it was quite an airplane to come back and that freezing mess.
Yeah. You ever hunt down there? You can place some good hunting down there.
Yeah, there's good hunting. And I got some friends down there. But they tried to get me to go, but I'm kind of. I can't cover my, both my knees are shot. I can't hardly get out.
Produce the original transcript.
I'm going to go real slow.
I understand.
You shouldn't have.
I've never been able to run nothing down.
Well, if I had to run it down, I never would get.
I can.
Yeah, just make sure that she's sending the original transcript and you can, you should have the court reporter seal on it. And if, you know, if you want.
That's what, yeah, that's what I got last time. I've just got an electronic, I guess, just for our.
But.
Well, you can get your.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Miles, I'm going to take it. We can rush up on that.
Ms. Clerk.
Yes.
Is Pat, how you say, Geron, what's?
Geron.
Is she down here?
Uh-huh.
Could you let me talk to her?
I can.
Good seeing you.
Hey, good seeing you.
See you. See you, John.
All right, good evening.
Dr. Howell, good to see you, my friend.
It's good to see you.
Your help good?
Fair. For my age, excellent.
Do what?
For my age, it's excellent.
We're lucky to still be here. You was talking about you joining, what was it, the Quonset in 1948?
Yeah.
Your son was brand spanking new then.
That's your year old.
Yeah, same day.
I was 23 years old then. Now I know you're 18.
88. You're about a year older than I am. Did you hear that Pamela Bagwell had a stroke? Fell on the floor? That's my mom's sister.
Of course,
She can get up and walk, but she can't talk. She can't get up and walk.
She sure had a lot of death in her family.
Yeah, early death, too. Well, her son died the same age you were.
Means we only one heartbeat.
Yes, cut that right. One heartbeat. That is exactly right.
No, I got it all in this one.
David, I didn't get to shake your hand.
Ms. Tisdale, good to have you. I didn't say welcome or anything. Good to have you.
Thank you so much. Pardon my cold hands.
That's all right. Well, mine's been pretty cold.
Thank you.